nucleus. So now this is the general structure of any atom. So let's look at what are the different types of different kinds of atoms. So every element has its own unique structure of an atom. Okay, so hydrogen has a different structure of an atom. It's basically the same, but the number of those protons, neutrons, and electrons will keep on changing. So every element has a unique structure of an atom with the number of either protons, electrons, something will change, okay? So let's take a look at how that is the case. So let's start with hydrogen. Hydrogen is the first element of the periodic table, okay? The second element of the periodic table is helium. The third is lithium, beryllium, boron, oxygen, fluorine, neon. Okay, so these are the first 12 elements of the periodic table. And you have to remember the first 20 elements of the periodic table in that particular order. Okay, so this is very, very important, guys, not just for this class, but if like at least till your 10th class, this is absolutely necessary. After that, if you want to pursue science, this is you have to know this. Okay, so make sure that you memorize the periodic the first 20 elements of the periodic table. Is there anyone who knows all the 20 elements of the periodic table?
Yeah.
So these are the first 20 elements of the periodic table. And let me just read them out to you. This is hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, sodium, magnesium, aluminum, silicon, phosphorus, sulfur, chlorine, argon, potassium, and calcium. So now you must be wondering, okay, if this is Al, it is aluminum. It's pretty easy to find out. If this is H, that is hydrogen. If this is N, this is nitrogen. O is oxygen. Si is silicon. He is helium. But then what about, you know, this element? What is this element?
Potassium.
Yeah, so if this is potassium, why am I writing it as K, whereas other elements I'm writing it
because we've named another element by P.
Correct. So why am I not writing this as PO then?
Because the Latin name starts with K.
Exactly. So the thing is, most of these elements, when they were discovered, we were naming them by using another language called, another language, which is Latin. So all these names were first given in their Latin form. And then we started naming them in their English form and then whatever. So all these elements that you see which have unusual lettering, they all have a Latin name, and that is why you have that letter for it, okay? So this K is actually potassium. All right, so now let us look at the structure, and this is the order, okay? This is, you have to remember this, hydrogen 1, helium 2, lithium 3, and so on, okay? You have to remember the order. And this 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on are called atomic numbers of that particular element. So hydrogen has an atomic number 1, helium has an atomic number 2, lithium has an atomic number 3, and so on till 118.